Hi there. I'm Matt with K15T, and let's talk about how you can use Confluence databases to manage events. Now, I know event management can be pretty complicated, and it can be tempting to go get a third-party tool to help you manage all the things. But with Confluence databases, we can do all of this in Confluence, where we're doing all the rest of the work for the event anyway. So here in the content tree, I have databases for the events and the sponsors and the speakers and the sessions, all the things that we're keeping track of on a day-to-day basis. And I can quickly reference them right from here. On any of these databases, I can do a quick search to find the important information people need, because we know that half of the job of an event planner is just finding information and answering people's questions. Now, databases in Confluence can have different types of fields to keep your entries orderly. So here I'm using a simple text field where people can enter the time for a session. There's a date field type, so people can quickly pick a date for that particular session. There's multi-select field types where people can pick one or more options. In this case, I'm just letting them pick one. You can even let them custom define their own option, but not here because I know the session lengths and people can pick the appropriate one. I'm the event manager. Because databases are built into Confluence, I can work right alongside the pages that I already have going. So here you can see I have an event session page. It contains all the really valuable information about the session, and I've used a database smart link to show the entry from the database that has all of the session information. The team can quickly collaborate on the page here to update the content about the session, and they can update the fields in the database directly. The powerful thing here is that when you update something in this entry, it also updates it in the Confluence database itself. So the information is always kept up to date across all of Confluence and time and space. I've also used entry fields to connect the sessions database to the speakers database, because our information is most powerful when it's interconnected. Now I can quickly look through all the session information and then also look at the information for that speaker. I can update the information for the speaker, and again, it saves to the speaker database. So very quickly, I can view and update the information I need across multiple databases. Really quick, if you are looking for written versions of information on how to use Confluence the best way possible, go to your favorite search engine and search for the Confluence Collaboration Hub. You will find all of K15T's amazing written and video content that you can share with your teammates so you can all use Confluence in the very best way possible. Now, let's get back to it. Now, sometimes as an event manager, you just need to do something quickly, like look at all the sessions and sort them by time to see if there's any conflicts. Like in this case, I see that I have the same speakers scheduled in the same time slot, and I can quickly just update that entry here, and it's updated everywhere. And because the data lives in Confluence, I can pull it all into anything, like, for example, a weekly blog post where I highlight all the speakers or all the sessions or maybe all the sponsorships. And again, I've used an entry field here to connect the sponsorships with the organizations doing that sponsorship. Now, at any time, a sponsorship could change, and if I update that in the database, even if someone comes back from vacation and reads the blog post a week later, they will see the most up-to-date information because I'm using Confluence databases to keep track of it all. Now, this is just event management with Confluence databases. There is so much more you can do in Confluence, so jump into another video in this series as we continue to explore how to use Confluence to share what you do best.